Gaddafi forces on the battleground.
Pro-Gaddafi forces.
Force pro-Gaddafi. L'avancée des soldats pro-Gaddafi semblait inexorable.
Les forces fidèles à Muammar Gaddafi.
Even though the NATO war in Libya is always presented as a humanitarian intervention, the media keep on referring to the regular Libyan army as the Gaddafi troops. Similarly, the expression the Al-Assad Brigades has been used to label the regular Syrian army. This ambiguous terminology was, and still is, continuously used by the media to deprive the legitimacy of the Libyan and Syrian people and their regular armies from them. Afterwards, the media, supported by notorious NGOs, spread the information that the Gaddafi forces had beefed themselves up with groups of African mercenaries.
Mercenaries shooting people in the eastern city of Benghazi.
Il est entouré d'un corps de mercenaires payés grassement.
African mercenaries.
To have mercenaries brought in from that state into Libya.
Geneviève Garrigos, president of Amnesty International France, was invited to speak by the channel France 24 on the 22nd of February 2011, which is the following day after the alleged Libyan army attack on their civilian population. This information has been since contradicted by numerous facts and testimonies.
Et d'ailleurs, nous, vendredi et samedi, on avait des informations comme quoi, dans les troupes qui étaient envoyées contre ces manifestants, il y aurait eu des mercenaires étrangers, justement pour accélérer le processus de répression.
Geneviève Garrigos claimed she had information regarding foreign mercenaries working on the side of the Libyan army. This claim will also be presented by the Dr. Slimane Bouchouiguer in the United Nations Human Rights Council.
These mercenaries seem to have carte blanche to pillage and kill all civilians without distinction.
Nevertheless, 5 months later, and after an inquiry by Donatella Rovera in Libya, the position of Geneviève Garrigos is entirely different.
Geneviève Garrigos, bonjour. Vous êtes la présidente d'Amnesty France. Je voudrais vous interroger sur plusieurs sujets. Premièrement, Donatella Rovera, conseillère sur la réaction aux crises chez Amnesty International, s'est rendue 3 mois en Libye. Elle fait état d'emprisonnement de citoyens libyens et étrangers par le Conseil national de transition, ce dernier nous les présentant comme des mercenaires. Que pouvez-vous nous dire à ce propos ?
Bonjour. Effectivement, dès le départ de la mise en œuvre des troupes anti-Kadhafi, on a eu rumeur de mercenaires qui agiraient à la solde de Kadhafi. Or, nos chercheurs qui se sont rendus sur place très tôt, puisque c'est mi-février, et ils en sont repartis fin juin, eh bien, ont constaté que dans les prisons, finalement, on ne trouvait que quelques personnes qui étaient incarcérées, et qui n'étaient même pas inculpées. Et de fait, ça a surtout été des rumeurs qui ont été colportées avec des accusations vis-à-vis de personnes qui soit étaient de peau foncée, voire noire, et qui pouvaient être des Libyens, parce qu'on oublie que les Libyens du Sud ne sont pas forcément de type arabe, et ou d'autre part des étrangers, ce qui a créé une espèce de peur, de xénophobie, et certains ont été maltraités, voire battus. Bon, certains ont été emprisonnés, et aujourd'hui, force est de constater qu'on n'a pas de preuves concrètes d'utilisation de forces mercenaires par Kadhafi.
Oui, en effet, puisque votre collègue dit également qu'elle n'a pas vu du tout de mercenaires et que tout ceci est une légende colportée par les médias. Est-ce que vous confirmez cette information ?
Absolument. Le travail fait par Donatella, et c'est pour ça qu'on a envoyé des chercheurs très tôt sur place, était de voir si véritablement on retrouvait des mercenaires. Or, ce n'est pas le cas. Et elle parle notamment du cas d'un jeune Algérien dont le patron a dû faire une attestation comme quoi il travaillait bien dans une pâtisserie alors qu'il était suspecté d'être mercenaire. Et à l'heure actuelle, vraiment, nous n'avons aucune trace, nous n'avons aucun élément confirmant ces rumeurs.
What was considered as information before is now categorized as a rumor by the same speaker. The 5 month period in between the two interviews enabled Amnesty International to hold an inquiry, although it is too late since the rumor has already been spread by the media with France 24 in the lead, thanks to the previous testimony of Geneviève Garrigos.
D'ailleurs, nous, vendredi et samedi, on avait des informations comme quoi, dans les troupes qui étaient envoyées contre ces manifestants, il y aurait eu des mercenaires étrangers.
On a eu rumeurs de mercenaires.
These rumors led to particularly dramatic outcomes. Indeed, being portrayed as being mercenaries, black Libyans were and are murdered in Libya. This documentary broadcasted on Libyan television reveals that black Libyans forming part of the regular army were killed with this rumor used as a justification externally. Yet, all the material goes to prove that this man was definitely Libyan.
Shahid Hisham Mansour Bajala Saleh, who can ask him to come to the Tanawi, and he will be able to do it.
This racial component of the Libyan war was in fact calculated and orchestrated in order to execute a geopolitical project of restructuring. It is a project imposing hatred and division amongst the Libyans and therefore fueling the distinction between light-skinned Libyans and dark-skinned Libyans. As demonstrated by the late Professor Samuel Huntington, this project intends to use the so-called dividing lines of civilizations, which are the following.
Okay, name those for me.
Okay, the civilizations are, first of all, obviously the West, consisting of North America and Western Europe primarily, Islam as a civilization, Orthodox civilization, of which Russia is the leading state, of course, Chinese or Sinic civilization, Hindu civilization, in which India is a major, the major state. And most people would classify Japan as a separate civilization all by itself. And then I would also add Latin America and Africa.
A geopolitical vision that serves the United States' interests and intends to divide Africa following the plans of the US State Department and Africa. But Libya is an Arabic country as well as a Muslim state and an African country. It seems therefore absurd to encompass it according to Huntington's theory. Nonetheless, this theory is in line with the scopes of NATO and the United States for the Balkanization of Africa. From this perspective, the Pan-African projects supported and driven by Gaddafi were standing in the way of the NATO. An African Union would lead to the unification of the African countries and enable the extraction of the African continent away from colonial domination. In the same way, the satellite Trascom project that was launched on the 21st of September 2007 enabled African independence to some extent regarding communications. The African continent will therefore only be able to resist imperialism if it unites and remains indifferent to the propaganda of imperialist media and NATO. As far as the so-called human rights NGOs are concerned, these NGOs are embedded components of the imperialist system. It is therefore necessary to question their discourses and positions, since a great volume of their assertions can't be verified and sometimes are open lies.
In being able to talk about what a great democracy we have and how the fact that we work together is what this is all about.